LeBron James and Dillon Brooks, two very contrasting players. One lets his game do the talking over and over again.
I'm not here for the bullshit. I'm ready to play, and that's it. I appreciate it.
And never really has a lot to say about the opponent, but more so, how can he help his ball club win the game? And then there's Dillon Brooks.
I don't care, he's old.
Continuously stirring the pot in the press and through his on-the-court antics. The NBA's villain, a valuable asset to Memphis, but often is forgotten about when discussing the core of their future. Point is, LeBron's an all-time great, and Dillon Brooks, well, he's a valuable asset for the Grizzlies, but at the same time, I wouldn't want to poke the bear. It's good to finally have you guys back. This is Marcus from the Bench Mob, and in today's video, we're going to be running through some of my personal favorite key moments, just to remind everybody to never talk trash to the king, because it never ends well. They say this is the day LeBron became the king. Almost half his life ago, at the age of 38, LeBron was 18 here. It begins with this. Trevor Ariza stated that LeBron James was overhyped before matching up against him in high school. To put in perspective, Trevor Ariza's from LA, LeBron's from Cleveland. Two very contrasting places and two very different players. LeBron St. Vincent St. Mary's would go on to defeat Ariza's Westchester High School team 78-52. LeBron had 52 points in that game, and Ariza ended up with 12. LeBron had as many points as Trevor's team combined, making it clear he was ready to take over the world.
Johnson down low. Oh! That's what they all came to see, the athleticism of LeBron James.
Here's another one. One of my personal favorites, being a Lakers fan.
There's someone I know for sure. Felt like he was just a little bit too excited about seeing me miss. That's what happened.
Anything else on that, or he knows who he is, or?
Yeah, I know who he is. he's part of the front office group. But he was really excited about me missing, that shot a little bit more extra than I would have liked. But he got a roof over his head for his team, obviously, and he was he showcased that. So. I knew I had another quarter, and fourth quarter is my favorite.
Tapped a number of times. McGee grabs it. McGee tried to feed Okoro, knocked away by LeBron. LeBron to the bucket, lays it in.
And watching this game, this was absolutely crazy. So in 2020 against the Cavs, after joining the Los Angeles Lakers, the Cavs and Lakers would finally match up. LeBron had 46 points, setting a new season high, and no one on either team scored more than 4 points in the fourth quarter except LeBron. The Lakers would go on to win 115-108. And then, of course, my all-time favorite, and I'm sure many people's all-time favorite. Just before Game 5 of the 2016 NBA Finals, Klay had this to say.
I don't know how the man feels, but obviously people have feelings, and people's feelings get hurt, even if they're called a bad word. I guess his feelings just got hurt. I mean, we've all been called plenty of bad words on the basketball court before. Some guys just react to it differently. All I can say for myself individually, I just try to ignore it or just let it fuel the fire. But I don't carry it with me when the job is done.
What happened? What Klay said?
Yeah, and what crosses the line?
No, I'm not. What did you say Klay said?
Klay said, I guess he just got his feelings hurt.
Oh my goodness.
The transcript will support that.
Shumpert in pursuit. James fakes, James drives, James finishes, and the foul.
Taken by Iguodala.
Off to the races, drive past Irving, gets inside. Layup blocked by James.
The second chase down block of the game.
Love finds James, who got free in an easy. James. Steps back. He tries another three.
That's
from the
good.
Perimeter. James against Rush. Leans in. Tried to draw the foul. Got him up. James. Thompson chased by LeBron James. Poked away from behind. Then releases. And Curry has to back up nothing. Irving fakes. Drives. James on the throwdown. On the attack. Goes to the goal. Left-handed lays it in. James puts up the three. And nails it. rattles in the second. Rebound tip taken by Spates. Final seconds. It's over. It's over.
But to be honest, I'm not entirely sure if we're going to get the same LeBron. I mean, he's 38 now. Do we expect him to still have this in him? Well, of course he does. But question is, does he even need to, playing alongside Anthony Davis and this Lakers core that they have? To no surprise, Dillon Brooks had this to say recently.
But, you know, I poke bears. I don't respect no one until they come and give me 40. I pride myself on, you know, what I do is defense and taking on any challenge that's on the board. If it's LeBron, if it's AD, if it's whoever, I play my heart out. So, you know, he knows that. You know, most of the NBA knows that. And I know my guys know that, and I try to get them on that same type of time every time we touch that floor.
Dillon Brooks knows deep down LeBron can have 40. I mean, it wasn't too long ago in 2019 where LeBron had 36 on Brooks, and he shot 60% from the field. So I'm not really too sure where he's coming from where he's saying, I wish I versed LeBron in Cleveland, because he literally did. Obviously, LeBron won't back down, but as a pass-first guy, LeBron knows he doesn't need to have 30 plus every night for the Lakers to win, especially right now for this team. I mean, everyone's healthy. They got it clicking. They're one of the best teams in the second half of the season with new acquisitions. LeBron knows he doesn't need to have 40. To me, it sounds like Dillon Brooks is trying to get Anthony Davis out of the game, especially because he's matched up with Xavier Tillman at the moment, who, not to mention, Xavier absolutely destroyed AD in that game too. But I don't really expect this to happen again. So if LeBron is going to have 40, which he could, I mean, I wouldn't see him backing down from a challenge. When the Lakers have so many guys who can score the ball, like Anthony Davis, who is probably their number one option, Ozzie Reaves, who's killing it, Rui, who's playing amazing, and then D'Angelo Russell, who had an off night, but we know what he's capable of, and even Malik Beasley. Brooks aims to contain LeBron by just letting him score and getting these guys out of the game. Because think about it, by allowing one player to score in LeBron James constantly, at the rim, from the mid, it takes away from the Lakers shooting threes, and it also takes away from their other scorers and a fully firing Lakers squad. And we saw that last game. LeBron had basically 30, leading the Lakers in scoring with Rui, and they lost by 10 to an undermanned Memphis Grizzlies team with no Steven Adams, Brandon Clark, or Ja Morant. But do I want LeBron to go for 40 plus? Of course, yeah. But as a Lakers fan, I kind of don't want him to go for 40 plus because I think it comes at our expense, and I much rather value us getting that win and LeBron having 20 and 10, getting these other guys involved, than him just going out and getting 40 and we lose. So what Dillon Brooks is actually doing here, I kind of respect. As a basketball fan, I wish there was more of this. But as a Lakers fan and a LeBron fan, Lakers just need to get the win. So let me know what you guys think. If you aren't subbed yet, why haven't you already? Make sure you check out all our recent videos. And for now, we'll catch you guys later.